out from the marsh, from the foots of the mist, hills and bogs, bearing God's hatred. Grendel comes, hoping to kill anyone he could trap on top of that high Herald. Up from the swampland, sliding silently towards the golden shining hall, he had visited Holgar's home before, known the way, but never before, nor after the night, found Herod, defended it so firmly, his reception. He journeyed forever joyous straight to the door, then snapped it open, tearing its iron with a touch, and rushed angrily over the threshold. He soared quickly across the inside
floor, snarling and fierce.
His eyes gleamed in the darkness, burning with a crimson light. Then he stopped, seeing the halls of crowded sleeping warriors, stuffed with rows of young soldiers resting together. And his heart laughed. He released the sight, intended to tear the life from these bodies. By morning, the monster's mind was hot with the thought of food and the feasting of his belly. Would soon know. But fate that night intended. Grendel was gnawed in broken bones of his last human supper. Human eyes were watching his evil steps.
Waiting to see his swift, hard claws, Grendel snatched the first gift he came to, ripping him apart, cutting his body to bits with powerful jaws, drank the blood from his veins, and bolted him down. Hands and feet, death and Grendel's great teeth came together, snapping his life shut. Then he stepped to another still body, clutched at Beowulf with his claws, grasped a strong-hearted, awakened sleeper, and he instantly seized himself. Claws bent back as Beowulf leaned up on one arm. That shepherd of evil, guardian of crime, knew at once nowhere on earth had he met a man whose hands were harder. His mind was flooded with fear, but nothing could take it all unto himself from the tight, hard grasp. Grendel's one thought was to run from Beowulf, flee back to his marsh and hide there. This was a different Herald than the hall he had just emptied. But Iglot's followers remembered the final boast and stand erect, stop the monster's flight, fasten those claws in the fist till they crack, crushing Grendel closer. This infamous killer fought for his freedom, wanting no flesh but retreat, desiring nothing but escape. His claws had been caught, he had been trapped. That trip to Hera was a miserable journey for the Wraith Monster.